some of the worst problems in developing countries, such as poverty, disease, and climate change. As part of the conference, Mr. Clinton agreed to his first one-on-one interview ever on Fox News Sunday. The goals were simple. 15 minutes for our sit-down split evenly between the global initiative and anything else we wanted to ask. But as you will see now in the full, unedited interview, that's not how it turned out. Mr. President, welcome to Fox News Sunday. In a recent issue of the New Yorker, you say, quote, I'm 60 years old and I damn near died, and I'm worried about how many lives I can save before I do die. Is that what drives you in your efforts to help in these developing countries?
Yes, but I don't mean that's kind of sort of morbid when you say it like that. I mean, but the way I said it, the tone in which I said it was actually.
Thank you.
I interview with former President Trump. This week, he hosted his second annual Global Initiative Forum in New York. More than $7 billion was spent to tackle some of the worst problems in developing countries, such as poverty, disease, and climate change. As part of the conference, Mr. Clinton agreed to his first one-on-one interview ever on Fox News Sunday. The goal was real simple. 15 minutes for our sit-down split evenly between the Global Initiative and anything else we wanted to ask. But as you'll see now, I interview with former President Trump. This week, he hosted his second annual global initiative show on the New Year. More than $7 billion was spent to tackle some of the worst problems in developing countries, such as poverty, disease, and climate change. As part of the conference, Mr. Clinton agreed to his first one-on-one interview ever on Fox News Sunday. The barriers were simple. 15 minutes for our sit-down split evenly between the global initiative and anything else we wanted to ask. But as you will see now in the full, unedited interview, that's not how it turned out.
It's President, welcome to Fox News Sunday.
Thank you.
In a recent issue of the New Yorker, you say, quote, I'm 60 years old and I'm damn near bad, and I'm worried about how many lives I can save before I do that. Is that what drives you in your efforts to help in these developing countries?
Yes, I really, but I don't mean, love to do. It is what I think I could do. That is, I have had a wonderful life. I got to be president. I got to live it off my dreams. Now I dodged the bullet and don't have problems. And I really think I could, I think I owe it to my fellow countrymen and people throughout the world to spend time saving my life, solving problems, helping people see the future. But as it happens, I love it. I mean, I feel like it's a gift. It's a great gift of the world and what it's been there.
You do this, and if you see here, you might be able to affect it in the world.
Thank you.
is what I love to do. It is what I think I should do. It is, I have had a wonderful life. I got to be president. I got to live it off my dreams. My God supported it with that health problem. And I really... Which I thought was actually almost whimsical and meaningless, that is, this is what I love to do. It is what I think I should do. That is, I have had a wonderful life, I got to be president, I got to live the life of my dreams, and I died to do it without heart problems. And I really think I should, I think I owe it to my fellow countrymen and people throughout the world to spend time saving the life, solving problems, helping people see the future. But as it happens, I love it. I mean, I feel like it's a great a gift. It's like a rewarding way to spend my life. Come on, thank you. I mean, again, we can love it, but this is what he said. He asked you if you could wind up doing more good as a former president than as a president. And you said, only if I live a long time.
Yeah, that's true.
How do you rate, compare the powers of being in office as president and what you can do out of office as a former president?
Well, when you're president, you can operate on a much broader scope. So, for example, you can simultaneously be trying to stop the genocide in Kosovo, you know, make peace in the Middle East, and pass a budget that gives millions of kids a chance to have after-school programs and has a huge increase in college aid at home. In other words, you've got a lot of different moving parts, and you can move them all at once. But you're also more at the mercy of events. That is, President Bush did not run for president to deal with 9/11, but once it happened, it wasn't as if he had an option. Once I looked at the economic, I'll give you much more mundane things. Once I looked at the economic data, the new data after I won the election, I realized that I would have to work much harder to reduce the deficit, and therefore I would have less money in my first year to invest